Oh my god, I'm getting tired of doing this. Third time we're trying this because my freaking mic was screwing up. Nintendo's E3 thoughts. Your brain explodes, 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 explodes. What an E3 from Nintendo so far. They still have 2 days to go after watching 10.5 hours straight from Nintendo's E3 today. Oh, so much to go over. This is going to be like a 40-45 minute video. But there's just so much to go over. Nintendo obviously won E3. Let's start off with the thing that was leaked right before E3, which was Star Fox. Are you freaking kidding me? Star Fox, Star Fox, Star Fox. I have a permanent smile on my face all damn day. Made by none other than Mr. Miyamoto himself. That's right, and he says this was actually secretly in the works for 6 years. It was going to be a Wii game, but now it's going to be a Wii U game, and it says, or he says it will be completed next year, and coming out next year, so yes! Star Fox, yes! And I don't care if I can't take credit for it, I am anyway. My Star Fox Tuesdays that I did before, and even my buddy Russ, we did it, man. We all did it. Yes! Star Fox, Star Fox, Star Fox, I'm so fucking happy! what else? In the interview with Polygon or whatever it was, Miyamoto said that you will also be able to fly in a helicopter in this game, in the Star Fox game, which is something new. Some people were freaking out about, oh, I guess you can't fly in the R-Wing. No, that's not true. If you look at the screenshot again on the OBA site, you can see the picture in on the TV is the R-Wing and Falco. I don't know if that's the one you're in or if that's Falco, but the R-Wings are still in there. So, Star Fox, I can't fucking believe it. I mean, thank God. Absolutely. Thank God. Seriously, I am so... Oh, I'm so happy. Everyone knows that I am a Star Fox fanboy. It's my second favorite franchise behind Zelda. It's... I can't fucking... I can't fathom it. It'll have been 9 years, I guess, by the time it comes out, just like Pikmin 3. When it was first leaked and I saw that picture of Miyamoto playing it, I literally screamed, "Woo!" Like, I literally screamed. And it was like, I was so freaking happy. I was bouncing off the walls, doing somersaults, not really, or, what's the word? I was gonna say backflips, but you know my point. I was over the moon happy, absolutely thrilled. And I mean, I haven't even gotten into this. We're still 2.5 minutes in, but I mean, I've only talked about Star Fox, but I can't stop not talking about it. It's fucking Star Fox, made by Miyamoto himself. How can that not be big blockbuster news? Seriously, and before their digital event even started, which I forgot to write this down in my notes, E3, or Nintendo was actually uploading stuff on YouTube, a few things, and they've done a hell of a lot more by now. But they did, there was two major things that stuck out for me. That Yu-Gi-Oh! Zexal game coming to North America finally after a fucking year. Although it doesn't have online, which is kind of stupid since every other fucking Yu-Gi-Oh! Game in existence has online. Well, everyone that was on a system that had online. And a Persona Q trailer. Oh, and there's also a Monster Hunter 4 one. But those were all badass, and that was before their digital event. So it was like Nintendo was really fighting right off the bat to show, hey, we're still here, even before their show. Great job. Nintendo literally did exactly what I said they needed to do, which is go from a game drought to opening the floodgates and flooding the market and just showing so many fucking good games. And Nintendo won E3. There's no ifs, ands, or buts about it. If you say otherwise, you're a fucking idiot or a Nintendo hater or something. Like, there's... If you didn't like this E3 from Nintendo, then what the fuck are you doing watching a Nintendo Direct in the first place? I mean, there is a few issues that I will get into throughout the Direct, but it's swarmed over by all the other good stuff. I mean, it's... How do I put it? It's like having a bag of coins, you know, like a few loonies with one or two pennies in there, where the pennies are... You have like 100 loonies or whatever, which is, you know, a Canadian dollar, and then... You have like 3 or 4 pennies in there, so there's little kind of things you're like, why is this in here? But it's not an issue. So let's move on. I mean, I could talk for Star Fox or about Star Fox and it's my excitement and everything for like hours and hours. But let's start off. They showed off the Nintendo digital event, which is only 40 minutes for some weird reason, but they had robot chicken animations in it, which was so random and hilarious. It was kind of funny. I give them credit for that. I like robot chicken. I haven't watched it in a long time. I don't even know if new episodes are still going, but I mean, Robot Chicken targets the core audience, like the older gamers, and Nintendo did target the core gamers this time. There was no freaking random shovelware casual game crap, which is very nice to see. It looks like Nintendo's finally decided to say, well, we tried with the casuals, we failed. I guess we have to focus on the core. And I mean, it's about fucking time. It's really about fucking time. Anyway, an epic intro where it was Iwata himself standing up in the dark, and then Reggie, and then they fought. Iwata versus Reggie. They were literally, punching, kicking, flipping, kicking each other. Unfortunately, I caught on a little late. I was like, I don't get where they're going with this, but it's badass. And it confirmed Mii's playable in Smash Bros. I was like, oh, fuck me. This was one of those few pennies in that bag I was talking about, one of my small issues. Now, granted, it's not, they're not, their movesets aren't generic. You can choose from like a class. You can have a Mii that's a fighter, or a Mii that's a sword guy, or a Mii that's a gun guy, like a shoots a blaster or whatever. So I mean, at least he gave him a little bit of effort into the Mii's, but I still don't fucking want to see Mii's. I mean, if you are on my friends list and we play a Smash Bros. Match and you use my or you use a Mii against me in a fight, I will remove you from my friends list. No ifs, ands, or buts about it. Seriously, they don't fucking belong in this game. But let's move on to more better news. They did Smash Bros. 4, blah blah blah. The Mii's have three classes. I already talked about that. Then they showed off for the 3DS version. A crap ton of modes and features and stuff in the 3DS version, and I couldn't even keep up with it. It was like 1,000 different fucking modes in like 20 seconds. It was ridiculous. What else? Then they revealed the release date for Smash Bros. 3DS, and they said summer before, but now it's October 3rd. That's not summer. That's like summer for people around the world, the other half of the world. So, that's a long ass wait. Gonna be brutally honest. There's not a Wii U or 3DS game, I don't think, coming out now until September. But from September, or for September, October, November, and December, it's big game, big game, big game, big game. So unfortunately, we do have to go all of June, all of July, all of August. One more 3-month game drought. It sucks, but I mean, it is what it is. It's not like Sony and on the PS4 and Xbox One are doing any better for these next 3 months anyway. So yeah. Then Reggie talked about the NFC toys, which was and they're actually called Amiibos, which is a weird name. It has the word Mii in it, but whatever. And they're like, they showed it off a little bit, not too much, just how you can, like, they'll work on Smash Bros. And they said they're gonna work on Mario Kart 8, so maybe that means DLC, like where you buy a Birdo statue and you can scan it on the gamepad, boom, you got Birdo unlocked in Mario Kart 8. Who knows? They didn't really go too much into that. They said they would show it off later, in the future. Then they moved on to developer stories, which was like developer, or like actual games with their developers and everything. Yoshi Land U, which I called it, which as everyone else called it, Yarn Yoshi, was finally revealed again. Hooray. And it has a name, and we were both wrong. Its official name is Yoshi's Woolly World, because it's made of wool. I was like, oh, Woolly World, good. I'm glad it's not Yarn Yoshi or Yoshi's Epic Yarn, but Yoshi's Woolly World, great name. It got a release window of 2015, which is a little unfortunate. I was hoping it'd be like September or something, but. Oh, and I gotta mention, before I forget, because I forgot to write it down in my notes, another issue I have, there was no Shin Megami Cross Fire Emblem. But then again, we still do have 2 more days of E3. And there was a Nintendo Roundtable tonight, but Reggie's like, make sure you watch it, but he didn't tell us where to watch it, because it wasn't on their stream or anything, so, I don't know. But anyway, Yoshi's Woolly World coming next year. It looks good, but it does have a little bit of that. Like, it's the same kind of style as Yoshi's New Island, where you eat a guy, he turns into an egg, you can throw them and collect stars and get to the goal. I was like, eh, that looks really boring in Yoshi's New Island. I didn't even get it because it was boring. And I watched Zach Scott Games play the whole thing, and it was kind of just so fucking boring. It's different and it looks fun, but at the same time, it looks boring. So I don't know how I can say it looks boring and fun, but yeah, I don't know. Whether I get it, I'm about 75% chance yes, 25% no right now. Anyway, up next, this was a really nice surprise. Bravo, Nintendo, you absolutely wowed me with this. This is something a lot of people have been asking for, especially since Super Mario 3D World came out, which was, if you played Super Mario 3D World, there was certain levels, there was only like five in the whole game, I think, where you played as Captain Toad and you kind of did a puzzle and collected green stars. A full-fledged Captain Toad game called Captain Toad's Treasure Tracker coming this year. Yes, sir, you bet. Yeah, baby. Fucking excited. Toad is my favorite character from the Mario universe. I don't know if everyone knows that, but there's a little tidbit of knowledge for you. Those games were fun in Mario 3D World, and just, I am so excited. It's probably gonna be like a, $20 eShop game, which is fine by me. But it's, no one was expecting that. I'm excited for it. They showed off a lot of gameplay, and it looks really, fun, relaxing. And it's gonna be a day one buy for me, no doubt about it, no hesitation. Absolutely great looking game. Then, boom! One of the, other than Star Fox, I would say the biggest thing, Zelda was revealed. Unfortunately, we didn't get a name, but it's was revealed, and it's a very open world game, surprisingly. Like, they didn't actually show how big it was, but just from the, they had like a live feed of it going, showing Link on a Epona. I'm guessing it was Epona, it was a horse, but in a field, and you could see really far in the distance, and it was huge. And then all of a sudden, this robotic monster thing comes up in the like 100 feet away or whatever, and shoots laser beams at him and starts chasing him, and it's like a cutscene. And Link, he's at this point in the game, he doesn't have his hood on, and he doesn't have a tunic or anything. It's just like his regular clothes. I guess it's the beginning of the game, so maybe that's what the story's about. It's like robotic creatures, something, I don't know. But and he pulls out the bow and he uses it, and it has like a, it's like a magical robotic bow. It's like, and it just looks amazing. It looks great. And now it doesn't look like the tech demo at all, which is kind of surprising, but at the same time, I mean, they kept us guessing, so that was a good thing. It looks kind of to me like Skyward Sword combined with Wind Waker HD with a little bit of a twist to it, like with a bit of a modification. It's like Wind Waker, Skyward Sword squished together, brightened up, open world with like almost like a Pixar movie. Like, people were saying it like, oh man, this almost looks like a Pixar movie, like it's that good. And it just, it looks good. It looks fucking good. And then I was, of course, so excited, and I still am fucking excited. Don't you even think I'm not. But then we hit a little snag that is, well, one of my personal snags. And I hate to have to say this, but I'm gonna hear so many, I told you so's, I told you so's. It's coming 2015. That really low blowed me, like it was a low ball, whatever you call it, like a cheap shot. And I was like, no. But I will say, while I was disappointed, the fact that we got Star Fox and that Captain Toad game, it was like, okay, I will forgive it because Star Fox is fucking Star Fox. So next year we have Star Fox and Zelda coming out. So that's really, really good news. What else here? After Zelda, they did the only 3DS game, which was a trailer for Pokemon Omega Ruby and Sapphire, or Alpha Sapphire, coming November 21st. It was a really good trailer, showed off gameplay. It looks like it plays like Pokemon X and Y. They showed off stuff like that. I don't remember if they showed off the Mega Evolutions. I don't remember. then they moved on to. Oh, I need a drink of water. I'm losing my voice here. Hang on. That's better. Then they moved on to Bayonetta 2, coming October 2014 this year. Also, it showed off you can wear have Bayonetta wear a Link outfit and a Samus outfit. That was really weird, but I mean, looking good. And I was reading apparently Kamiya himself. He says that the Wii U box art for Bayonetta 2 he thinks looks like utter junk. I thought that was interesting. Oh, and by the way, if you buy Bayonetta 2 physically, like not on the eShop, you get Bayonetta 1 included for free, but if you buy it on the eShop, you don't get the free copy of the first one. So, nice little job there with giving us Bayonetta 1 for free. After that was Hyrule Warriors. Bleh. Don't care. They showed off Midna was playable and Zelda as well. Apparently, there's 10 characters you can play as in total, but only 4 are revealed so far. It's coming September 26th. I don't care. I don't care. I don't care. Then here was another lovely surprise. Kirby and the Rainbow Cruise coming 2015 for the Wii U. So a Kirby game for the Wii U. I was thinking it was the HAL Laboratories said that they wanted to do a 3D Kirby game on the Wii U. Maybe that's what they'll do next, but I wasn't expecting this one. Maybe it's made by HAL. I don't even know. I don't know if they said. But a Wii U Kirby game, I mean, right after the 3DS one, that was it was a good move. It does look a little different. It's not like it doesn't play like Kirby's Triple Deluxe. You like draw swirls with the stylus, and like Kirby rolls around. Like I can't even describe it. You'd have to see it yourself. what else? Oh yes, there was this. We moved on to Monolith Soft's X, which has a full name now, which is called Xenoblade Chronicles X. A little unoriginal on the name. It's called Xenoblade Chronicles again, just with the X added, so it's kind of weird. But I'm not going to complain about the name. Showed off this like a lot of cutscenes and gameplay and whatnot. Looks really good, absolutely phenomenal. But the slight issue is it was delayed till next year, which was like it's gonna make everyone go what? 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 It was supposed to be a worldwide release, but it wasn't. So, oh well. It's coming next year. Probably gonna be first half of the year though. After that, Mario Maker was revealed, and it is indeed real. So, woohoo! I think it's on the Wii U and the 3DS. They didn't really specify. So that's cool. They showed off, making some stages and whatnot. It was really good, really good, really good. Looks like a fun little thing. It'll probably be an eShop $10 game or something. You can also make levels from old school style Mario, like the original Super Mario Bros., or you can make them into the new Super Mario Bros. U style, so that was nice. Up next after that, they revealed a game called a Wii U exclusive called Splatoon. At first, I didn't know what to expect from this. I thought it was an indie game, but it's a online 4 versus 4 multiplayer third person shooter paintball, or not paintball, well, kind of like a paintball game, but you use ink to cover the area in the map, and whoever has the most area covered by the end wins. You can shoot each other. There's like a rocket ink gun and a sniper ink gun, apparently. And you can turn into a squid, and when you're a squid, you can hide in the ink and move really fast and whatnot. So it's quite interesting. I actually gotta say, I watched probably an hour, a little bit more maybe, of repetitious gameplay of it, and like on the same two levels, and I was just like, I could watch this all day. Like it looks really, really fun as a shooter on the Wii U. So yeah. Then there was a Smash Bros. Video, a CGI thing. It was showing off Kid Icarus as a cutscene thing, like as an anime, and it was Link against Pit, and Link was kicking Pit's ass, and Palutena saves the day, and Palutena revealed to be playable in Smash Bros. And then there was a bit of gameplay showing her as playable. So we got a new character again, and it's another female fighter, which is always a good thing. Not a Bomberman, unfortunately, but at least it's not Pac-Man. Then Miyamoto teased about Star Fox again and said, like, yes, I'm working on Star Fox, blah blah blah. Won't be till next year. And then on IGN, they revealed a Wii U exclusive game after the digital event, because that was the end of the digital event. It was a new Wii U third-party exclusive. So we like before we had Bayonetta 2 was revealed as a shocker, and was there another one like Sonic being Wii U exclusives and everything? This one was called Devil's Third. Honestly, not gonna lie, not my kind of game. I don't care for it like at all. But I know there's a lot of people that are surprised about this, and they are fans of the game. It's like a shooter. Well, military dropping bombs, military stabbing, cutting, shooting, violent game. And it didn't do it for me, but I mean, at the same time, I know it's a big deal. that Nintendo managed to secure another Wii U third-party exclusive, which is nice. So yeah, quite exciting for that. Then I wrote down a note here saying that so there was no 3DS game shown except for Pokemon, except for, you know, on Nintendo's YouTube channel, like I said, they did Yu-Gi-Oh! And stuff like that, and Persona Q Shadows of the Labyrinth, and some indie games and whatnot. No Metroid was revealed, and I didn't, like I said, there wasn't going to be one for Wii U. Then again, E3 still has two more days for Nintendo, so a 3DS one could be shown, because like I said, we haven't seen any 3DS games at E3 itself, except for Pokemon Omega Rubies and Alpha Sapphire. And no Miyamoto's new IP. Now, the thing about that is, I have to slightly rephrase how I wrote that, rephrase how I say that, because they didn't show off whatever Steam was, S-T-E-A-M, Strike Team Eliminating the Alien Menace, at least not yet for E3, maybe they'll do it in the next 2 days, who knows, but Miyamoto did show off, showed off two new IPs, so you definitely can't say, especially with Splatoon and everything, and Captain Toad's Adventure or whatever, Treasure Tracker, you can't, people who are saying, give us new IPs, Nintendo, they definitely gave you a few this year, so if you're still bitching, it's because, oh, I don't like these new IPs, you can't have your cake and eat it too, you got new IPs, either you like it or you don't, you can't bitch at them because they did give you new IPs, but anyway, so maybe Miyamoto's true new IP himself is Steam, we haven't seen it yet, maybe he's just not going to reveal whatever it is yet anyway. It's not going to be Star Fox because he says it's a new IP, and Star Fox is not a new IP. And then I have a note here about, apparently it was revealed, I don't know, it was like revealed on a part of a video that I missed or something, but it was uploaded to Nintendo's YouTube channel, and this was also predicted by me, Mario Party 10 revealed for the Wii U. At first I heard that, I was like, oh yes, Mario Party 10, very exciting. I watched the trailer, and the minigames look good, they look better, but once again, Nintendo's being stupid, and they broke the, they don't bring back the good formula, they have everyone going in one cart again, fighting bosses, getting to the edge of the map, or the end of the level. That's not what Mario Party is. Let everyone go around on their own, on their every turn, go in which direction, and collect the star. That's what Mario Party needs. After that was... Oh yeah, and also on YouTube they showed off Sonic Boom, a Wii U trailer, and a 3DS trailer. It's coming out in November. I don't remember if they did an actual release date, but it was November anyway. Then I began watching Twitch's stream of Nintendo, and luckily there was no lag. There was, like, you know, a hiccup every, you know, half hour or something, where there was just a quick one-second issue, but it was nothing. It was a big issue. So the Treehouse, how it worked was they had the developers there, and they were talking about each game individually, showing off gameplay, having the developers play it, and while they talked about it, and they literally spent like 20 minutes to a half an hour on each game, and it was quite nice. If Nintendo does that for every E3 from now on, they should be good, because Nintendo not only won E3, but like they won every fucking E3. I don't even know if they need to show up next year. They won. They did so fucking well this year. So they started off again, taking a look at Toad's Treasure Tracker, and I'm a big Toad fan, as I said, so we had about 20 minutes or so where they played off a few levels and talked about it. Looks good, looks fun, I'm getting it, that's all I need to say. Then they moved on to Splatoon, again, that shooter, third-person shooter that's an ink game where you're like half-human, half-squid. It looks really fun, I'm not gonna lie. It's not a shovelware casual crap. I think it could honestly be kind of like what Plants for Zombies Garden Warfare is for the Xbox One, but for the Wii U. I mean, it's not quite the same, but it's a cartoony shooter-ish type fun shooter game. So I can't wait for that. And they really went on and on, and they said, oh, Miyamoto's here, so we gotta let it go, and then I guess there was some kind of delay. Miyamoto was late for a few minutes or something, so they kept showing another round of Splatoon or whatever, so people in the comments were literally just like, you can't just promise us Miyamoto and then go back to this. It's like, hurry up. So people were getting antsy to see Miyamoto. So Miyamoto showed up after that. He showed off his first... Apparently he's been working on a lot of crap. Apparently Miyamoto's responsible for that last system update for the Wii U, so I guess that's good. He's responsible for, you know, I think he's still involved with that Zelda game, with the new one. Star Fox and two other games. Plus, we don't even know if it's if. Well, actually, now that I think about it, maybe one of these two games that he revealed of his is his new IP. I kind of hope not, because they just kind of seem a little lacking. You can tell both of these other the two games I'm about to get into, they were in very early development. They were like probably 10% done, maybe. It was in like a working order, but just to showcase what he's going for. No official names, but the first one was called Giant Robot, where you're literally it was you're in a city in a giant robot, like inside the head, and on your TV screen it's like a camera way far away showing your robot from a distance, and on the gamepad it's like your view from looking out the robot's eyes, and you have to move around the gamepad motion control wise, and you have to like leverage your body and use this two sticks, one the left stick for your left arm, the right arm for your or right stick for your right arm, and you have to like knock over the other robots. All you have to do is push them over, and they're like buildings that turn into robots. So it kind of reminded me of Power Rangers, you know, in the Megazord, where all the Power Rangers go inside the robot and they control it. But at the same time, it looked really unfinished, unpolished. Like the detail was not there, but the concept was kind of interesting. So it's a eh right now. It's interesting. That's all I have to say. Then they moved on to a game called Guard of Miyamoto's, which not really too much to say. It's you're kind of a strategic game. You place cameras all over a base, and then robots try and come in and destroy the generator or whatever at the middle of your base. And you're moving around the gamepad, and on your gamepad you have 12 different camera angles, like 12 different buttons for each camera that you place around, and you have to switch between them all. And you know, shoot the cameras can shoot laser beams at the robots, and you have to beat the level and defeat all the robots and protect your core or generator or whatever it is. So it's again, it was a really early development game, nothing too, you know, brag-worthy, but it's we'll see where it goes in the future. He didn't show Star Fox, but he did mention it, and yes, he once again confirmed. He's like, "Yes, I'm working on Star Fox, and we're not going to show it off until we're satisfied with the way it looks, and it should be out next year." So more than likely, there's going to be a Nintendo Direct sometime this year that's either going to have Star Fox included, where they'll finally reveal it. Or, you know, there'll be a direct all about Iwata, or Iwata, Miyamoto and his games. But Star Fox coming next year. Damn, can't wait. Oh, 27 minutes, my goodness. Where do I go from there? Then we got like a 30-minute video of Xenoblade Chronicles X. It was awesome. They showed off the intro. Where you like crash in a pod, you're found by a girl, you're free. They were free roaming around, fighting some creatures. They did a boss battle thing where they fought this these three big creature things. Looking good, looking good. I just don't like how it was delayed till next year, but it is what it is. So we saw a lot of good stuff there. It's kind of funny how half the game was in Japanese, half was in English. Like all the voices was in Japanese, but every once in a while I get some English words popping up. Oh, I'm wearing out my voice here. After that, then they went to Hyrule Warriors, which I'm gonna be brutally honest, this just dragged on and on for like 30, 35 minutes, and people were, like, a lot of people in the audience or in the comments were just not having it. I was bored. I was like, just move on to the next game. This is so shitty. I am not getting this game. The AI was so bad. He was walking around, running through like hundreds of enemies, and they were barely moving. You're like, aren't you gonna fight back? And they're like, oh, I don't know, I'm just gonna sit here. The whole game seems to be literally about, and he played as Midna, which was kind of cool, but at the same time, it's like, go here, go to this room, clear out all the enemies, go to this room, clear out all the enemies, go to this room, clear out all the enemies, and that's all the game is. So I was like, ugh, whatever, don't care, it's Dynasty Warriors, it's crap, like I said. I'm not getting it, it's not Zelda, it's just a crap thing. It's supposed to pay tribute, but it's more of insulting Zelda, really. what else? Then finally, when that was over, we went back to Splatoon, because why not? It's always a good time when you're watching more Splatoon, I guess. Didn't last too long, it was about maybe 7 minutes or something while they're setting up the next thing, which was Mario Maker. They took a good look at it and they had one of the developers there talking. I forget what his name is, Tezuku, Tezaka, something, I don't know. I think it's the same guy behind Yoshi's Woolly World and whatnot, and Yoshi's New Island. I could be wrong, but so they were showing off some level building and some ones that they had made, like the people at E3 and whatnot. And it looks fun. It looks pretty interesting. I don't need to go into too much detail. It's, if it's like a $10 or something eShop game, I'll probably get it and download, or I'll make some maps, and the OBA army can try and beat some of my maps if they want. then after that was the Smash Bros. Tournament. Wasn't originally sure if I was even gonna watch this, but since it was literally following the E3 Treehouse on the same Nintendo Twitch channel, I was like, all right, I'll watch it. And what's his name? Sakurai was there, which is kind of nice to see. No reveal trailer at the whole thing, which is kind of like, oh. And that's right, we didn't get Ness, we didn't get Captain Falcon or Jigglypuff revealed, which is kind of disappointing. But then again, we still do have 2 days, and there is that Smash Bros. Direct supposedly. That's 90 minutes, or not direct, or video, or whatever the frick it is. I don't even know if it's supposed to be part of this conference roundtable thing that's no one can seem to find. But anyway, there was a lot of fans there. There was a lot of people playing. There were 16 people playing, and then there was media people and supposed celebrities like Zelda Williams, who came out with a Majora's Mask mask toy thing. So more teasing. Oh, and Hyrule Warriors, when they used the hookshot, they actually hookshotted through the clouds, hit the moon, which is the moon from Majora's Mask, and pulled it down on a dragon. I was like, oh, more hinting at Majora's Mask, which whenever they talk about 3DS games, I'm betting, Majora's Mask 3D will be revealed. Because there was just too many teases about it. There was like two of them this whole day. Anyway, in the tournament there was going to be a grand champion winner, and then there was a fan picked winner, like a fan voted one, who's not necessarily the one who won the whole thing, but just in the general idea, who won, had the most votes from people for their favorite or whatever. And Star Fox was the favorite pick, actually. There was a person who was using, or a person was using Star Fox, so Star Fox was actually nominated and won the Smash Bros. Picture or pick of the, how do you say it, viewers vote or something like that, champion or whatever. So very fitting how a new Star Fox game comes out, or is coming out. It was revealed, teased, whatever, and then the Star Fox wins, people pick or whatever. So it's like, it's Star Fox's time. You can just feel it. You can just feel it. So that was nice. Now the actual winner of this Smash Bros. Tournament was a guy not a lot of people liked, to be brutally honest. He got booed quite a bit. He was playing as Zero Suit Samus the whole time because you had to stay with your same character. That's right, my prediction of Villager was wrong. There was a person using Villager and only went to the semifinals before being eliminated. But in the final one-on-one match with no items, it was Kirby against Zero Suit Samus. And Zero Suit Samus, it came down to the end of the time limit. It was down to one life apiece. It was like 1 minute left on the clock. Each of them had one life left, zero damage done. And Kirby was on the offense trying to get it done. And me and a friend of mine who were watching it, we were like, come on, Kirby, we don't like this guy. He's an asshole. He's a coward. He just spams the same combo. And that's all he does, is he spams the power whip, or whatever you call it, from Zero Suit Samus. And literally, the last 20 seconds of the fight, he just kept staying to the top of the stage on Battlefield and jumping around and avoiding him. He wouldn't fight. He was like, he purposely delayed fighting so he could get the sudden death where it's an instant kill, basically. And then he ended up winning. So Zero Suit Samus wins because of a fucking coward. And he calls himself MLG. He calls himself one of the best Smash Bros. Players in the world. I mean, are you kidding me? How is that proving you're the best? You're the best at being a coward and spamming, really. And when everyone was playing with GameCube controllers, so that was awesome to see. So I don't like that part. That's another little issue I had, was him winning because of, being a little bitch and just running away and being a coward. But it is what it is. Then Reggie himself came out and presented the trophy to the Star Fox guy, and then the big trophy to the Zero Suit Samus guy, and they got a picture. And the runner-up guy, who was playing Kirby, said to Reggie, he challenged him to a match, and he's like, oh, not now, but maybe next time when with the 3DS version. He says he even said himself, he plays all Nintendo games, Reggie does, but he's not good at Smash Bros. He said, but he said, and I quote, the next time, I'll ch no, how did he say it? Next time I'll challenge, or I'll fight you on Smash Bros. And I'll kick your ass. I was like, oh, Reggie swore, really? It's like the good old Reggie's back, the good one from you know, back when he introduced himself and he's like, "My name's Reggie, I'm about kicking ass and taking names." That was the Reggie we needed. This is the Reggie we need. Hopefully he stays around and not, it wasn't just a one-time thing, because that would just be stupid. Yeah, he says, "Next time I'll be back to kick your ass," to the guy, so that was pretty badass. What else? No quality of life things were shown, even though Iwata had said they were, except, although, you know, Iwata himself wasn't able to be there because of his health issues, so maybe that's why he didn't show it off, because he wanted to show him off himself, and he wasn't there. Although I'm still going to say, with Iwata not being there, it was a nice thing. It really actually benefited, in my opinion, because we didn't need to hear a lot of, "Please understand, blah, 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 blah," crap. When there was people in the audience dressed up as Reggie and Iwata, that was hilarious. There's a lot of people in the audience dressed up as Smash Bros. Characters and stuff. So that was kind of nice. I think the most epic moment in the Smash tournament was when a guy used the Mega Man Smash Ball or whatever, and it was just, everyone was freaking out with, like, the six different Mega Man or whatever it was, using the energy beams or whatever. It was pretty crazy. There was no Mario game, like, no actual, you know, Mario Galaxy 3 or Sunshine 2, or no actual main Mario game revealed, so yes, thank you for not having Mario around. I mean, there was Mario Party revealed, but that's a spin-off. Just let Mario rest for a while. Seriously, I'm thankful for that. Yeah. Also, there was revealed, it was on a YouTube channel, I think, Nintendo's YouTube channel, was Mario vs. Donkey Kong for Wii U. It is indeed a real game, if you remember that tech demo from before. So what did I say? And I even said it on the OBA forums, I think. "I bet you it's going to be turned into a game. I bet you anything." Lo and behold, again, I'm right. It's a real game. So I think that's going to do it, though. I've talked for a long time. 36 minutes is a long fucking time. So overall, I'm going to give Nintendo a 9 out of 10. That's right, not a perfect, even though I'm saying it's the best E3 of all freaking time. And that's just because of those small little issues about Miis being in Smash Bros., Zelda being next year. But then again, we do have Zelda Smash Bros., or Zelda X and Star Fox all next year. Those are to look forward to. Star Fox, as you know, I'm going to buy that day one. I'm going to pre-order that as soon as I freaking can. And oh my goodness, can't wait to play that on OBA games for sure. But yeah, I'm going to give them a 9 out of 10 because of that. And Hyrule Warriors, that was really the only absolutely crap part of the whole entire Nintendo thing for the first day here. I might do another video on Nintendo's things tomorrow if there's anything major to go over, and then especially the third day, we'll see. But really good show from Nintendo. They absolutely obliterated Sony and Microsoft. I'm sorry, it's just the way it is. Sony came in second, Microsoft came in third, Ubisoft came in dead last. I've seen a lot of people say Ubisoft did really good, but that Just Dance thing was just terrible. And then, you know, going from woohoo, cheers, to boo, 2 seconds later, to cheers, to boo, to cheers, to boo. But, yeah, it was 10.5 hours. I mean, I gotta say, Nintendo, the magic is back. You brought it back. Now, I'm not gonna say I'm 100% back on board with Nintendo, because I'm not. I'm just not. That would be too easy for them. They did do what they needed to do, and it was fucking amazing. I'm 50% back on course with being, you know, on Nintendo, being on good terms with Nintendo, I'd say. Just 50%. And you're thinking, wow, what do you really have to do to get the other 50%? Simple. There's really only one topic that needs to be addressed now, which is, well, Party Chat, added to the Wii U. But mainly, the real only issue is Miiverse needs to be fixed. That's really only the last thing left. If Miiverse gets either taken down completely, just removed, or if the admins are fired and replaced moderators or something, and it's, you know, somehow made miraculously better, then you'll have gotten me back, 75% to maybe 90%, I'll say. But that's about it. Nintendo, you did absolutely everything right, pretty much. The magic was definitely there, the old Nintendo magic from before, like from back in the good old days. There was a few hiccups here and there, but overall, it was just, you knocked it out of the park every time. It was just game, 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 game. Just, it was phenomenal. Absolutely phenomenal. I can't bash Nintendo at all for this. Sony and Microsoft just look like afterthoughts from this. And there's no way. Now, let me get correct this. Let me say one thing here. Even with everything said and shown, do I think the Wii U is guaranteed to be saved? No. No, no, no. And you're thinking, but you just talked it up so much. How can you possibly think the other systems will do better? Now, I didn't say Xbox will do better. PS4 is really the only Wii U can the only competition for the Wii U, that is, in my opinion. But I have to be honest. I think what this Nintendo E3 did, or what this E3 for Nintendo did, was they made it so the Wii U cannot be ignored anymore. Everyone who watched Nintendo's E3, they had their eyes opened. The Wii U is not a system to be ignored anymore. So I think, not necessarily that the Wii U is going to be saved, but I think a lot more people are going to be aware of the Wii U and the games, and it'll be interesting to see how Star Fox does sales-wise and everything. I mean, if I have to, I'll buy like maybe I'll buy a second copy and give it away for free on OBA Games, although it'd have to be for a Canadian because region lock. But who knows? That's not a guarantee. That was just an idea. Don't get ahead of yourself. So yeah, I think that's gonna do it. I don't think I miss talking about anything else really. That was just such a good E3. I was doing backflips. I was doing fucking backflips when Star Fox was announced. I can't even believe it. Next year though, we can, well, I don't even know if we have to wait till next year, but we'll be focusing, I guess we can start focusing on F-Zero next, and 1080 snowboarding and wave race and stuff like that. Who knows? But it seems like Nintendo did focus on the core. Are they still listening? Until I see a Miiverse fix and a party chat added, I can't say that Nintendo's fully listening. But still, overall, Nintendo E3 was it was destroyed. You did everything absolutely flawlessly, perfectly, or pretty much near perfect. There wasn't too much more I could ask, and I'm gonna wrap up this video because I could probably end up delaying this another 20 minutes or so. So I'm Original Blood Ace. As always, stay tuned. Let me know what you think. I've seen a few people actually like try and bash the Nintendo Direct, and they're just like, "Oh, same old Mario and Zelda." It's like, what Mario? But seriously, phenomenal. That Zelda video was, or the reveal. I don't know when we'll get a name. Probably sometime this year, but it was awesome, and I can't wait. It looks like it. Can it beat Ocarina of Time? I don't know. But it might be able to take second place. It might be able to boot Wind Waker down to third, which would boot Ocarina or Link Between Worlds of Mine down to fourth. We'll see. We'll see. It definitely has a chance of topping Wind Waker, or I mean Ocarina of Time. But we'll see. So yeah, I'm Original Blood. Stay tuned. As always, more videos coming soon. Let me know what you thought of Nintendo's Direct or their E3 Digital event, and if you watched all 7 hours or whatever of their Twitch and all that in the Smash Bros. Tournament, let me know. That's it. That's gonna do it for this video. I'm tired of talking. Stay tuned. More videos coming soon, as always.
The cult of personality. The cult of personality.